First, we give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the one who is head of our life. We have so much to be thankful for because of his love towards us when we were yet sinners. He died for the sin of the whole entire world. He died that we might live. And we have that hope through the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We know we can't do nothing pleasing in him in the natural. And regardless how good we may think we are and good thing that we are doing, but none of those things move God until we accept him for our personal Savior. How you know that, Atkin? The natural man know not the things of God, neither can they know them because they are spiritually discerned. So at your level best, amen. When you do the best that you can do, it won't mean a thing in the new life. Amen. You must be born again on today. Amen. Before we have a word of prayer, on today we want you to look at the book of Ephesians, the second chapter, and it entirely. And I think that about 22 verses, amen, we are going there. But we want to just have a word of prayer at this time. Our Father in heaven, it's again, it's a day, it's another opportunity that you have given us as we live, move, and have our beings. And ask the Lord to open up my spiritual understanding that I may be able to write the divide your truths. And we're going to give you the honor, and we're going to give you all the praise for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. God bless you. On today, our lesson of coming out of the book of Ephesians, the second chapter, first through the 22nd verse. And we, our subject is the old condition is dead to God. The new condition is alive to God. The old condition that we are talking about when we were born by our mother womb. The new condition is talking about when we were born, amen, by the blood of Jesus. Jesus dying on the cross for the sin of the whole entire world, and we accept his offer of eternal life. So we're going to be dealing with the old condition, talking about the unsaved before we accept Jesus Christ for our personal Savior, and the new condition when we accept Jesus Christ for our personal Savior. So this is what we're going to be talking about today. In that new condition, we are saved by grace. By grace we are saved, and that not we ourselves. The old condition, do the best you can, it still don't mean nothing in God's eyesight because we are still lost and we don't have no communication with the spiritual man. And we need to recognize that fact. Amen. We're going on now to the Word of God. Amen. But before I go in the Word of God, I have a little more to say before I go to the lesson dealing with the old man. The old condition knows nothing about God's love. Mm. God's peace, God's joy. The condition, amen, is dead from God. And the only way that the sinner can come alive is to accept Jesus Christ for our personal Savior. Receive the new condition. You can, amen, only receive it and come alive by confessing with the mouth and believing in the heart that it was God raised Jesus from the dead, Amen. The same shall be saved. Amen. And he said, I give you eternal life. And I can't express this no better, sister and brother, because I still can be member of local assembly and still lost. Mm-hmm. But I cannot know who Jesus is in a new condition and be lost. Amen. God have ordained it. Amen, sister and brother. So we're going to be talking about, amen, the new condition and the old condition. Amen. We come alive in the new condition. It read like this, amen, the Ephesians, the second chapter and the first verse. And you, amen, have he quickened. New condition. Oh, I hope we see this. That means you've been born again. Amen, new condition. Who were dead in the old condition, we were dead. Trespass, amen, trespass and sin. That means dead from God. That means no communication with God. We just know worldly thing. But when we accept him for our personal Savior, he gives us eternal and everlasting life. And we become a new creation in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. After when that happened, the moment that you accept Jesus Christ for your personal Savior, the moment that you, amen, change your mind and begin to pray and ask the God, amen, to give you this new condition. He do it by you confessing with the mouth and believing in the heart that if God raised Jesus from the dead, the same shall be saved. Then he said, I give you eternal life. And this is the new condition, sister and brother. Let's go on down now to this second verse here. Wherein, in time past, ye walked according to the course of this world. Amen. The old condition, sister and brother, with no connection with Christ. Amen. According to the prince of the power, amen, of the air. Amen. The spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Talking about those who have not accepted Jesus Christ for our personal Savior. Maybe I need to stop here. And sister and brother, if we don't accept him, while the blood is running warm in our vein, there's no hope.
Amen.
Amen. If you die out of the ark of safety, amen, sister and brother, there's one place, amen, one place for you. That is, amen, die and then go to hell. Amen, and stay there throughout eternity. Amen, according to the scripture, that what the word tell us, amen. So we have to do this thing, accept him, and become with this new man, while the blood is yet running warm in our vein.
Amen.
Amen. You ain't gonna get it after death. It's too late. Amen. Let's move on down, sister and brothers, to the third verse, among whom also we all had our conversation in time past and the lust of the flesh. Do I need to pause here? Sure. Amen. That's where every one of us come from. We've come from that through Adam. When Adam ate the forbidden fruit, sister and brother, Amen. We were born, but we were born dead from him. Amen. But we come alive through the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ the moment that we accept him for our personal Savior. Amen. The third verse again. Among whom also we had our conversation in time past and the lust, the desires of the flesh. Amen. Fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, which don't have no connection with spiritual things. Amen. And were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Amen. And sister and brother, that's where all of us come from. But is there any hope? Yes, that hope through the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let's move on down to this fourth verse here. But God, amen, God turned things around, sister and brother. He, amen, and talked about the natural man and, amen, the children of wrath. Now the Bible tells us God is able to turn these things around. He said, but God, amen, God, who is rich in mercy for his great love, wherein he loved us. He loved us, sister and brother, when we wasn't lovable.
Amen.
He loved us and he gave us that hope. And it's not God's will that any would perish. If one would perish, he would perish because of his own unbelief. We have to believe that he is, a rewarder, the those that diligently seek him. The Bible tells us, seek and you shall find, knock at the door and you shall be saved. Let's look at this fifth verse. Amen. Even when we were dead, therefore we accept him for our personal Savior. Dead in what? In sin. Amen. Have quickened us together, who have brought us out of darkness over into the marvelous light. Amen. With Christ, by grace you are saved. Amen. We are saved when we make Jesus our choice. I got to go back over this fifth verse again. Even when we were dead in sin, have, amen, quickened us together with Christ, by grace ye are saved. Amen. That means, sister and brother, we have to have a connection with him if we gonna be saved. That the only hope we have, our hope lies in the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ through his death bearer and his resurrection. Amen. Even now, what is the Lord doing? He got his arm wide open. Amen. And what did he say? Come unto me, all that are laden and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Amen. The only way you can get it is God's way. God has a plan, and God's plan alone will work. Let's move on down, sister and brother, to the sixth verse. Amen. And have raised us up together. Talk about them who have accepted Jesus Christ now for our personal Savior. And made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. We have a connection. We have the indwelling Holy Spirit that lead and guide us into all truth. Amen. And that is to everyone that believe what? The finished work of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He is able to do so. Amen. And we move on down to the seventh verse. That in ages to come he might show the exceedingly richness of his grace. Amen. In his kindness toward us through Jesus Christ. You leave Christ out of it. Amen. What kind of hope we have?
No.
You don't have no hope. Amen. He the author and the finisher of our faith, sisters and brothers. Let's move on down to this 8th verse here. Amen. For by grace ye are saved through faith. Amen. That not yourself. Amen. It is the gift of God. So you have to give him all that honor then. If it's a gift then, sister and brother, how much will we have to pay for it? Nothing.
Amen.
Somebody give you a gift, amen. You ain't got to be looking for some return. Amen. What return to us is eternal life.
Amen.
Amen. He has loved us so well. The Bible tells us, amen. Maybe we say, well, I can do it, I can work it out. Well, let's look at this 9th verse. Not a works. I'm getting this out of the King James Bible. Amen. Least any man should boast. You can't boast in your goodness. Amen. The best we can do is no more than filthy rags. If we're going to get it, we're going to get it whose way? We're going to get it God's way. God has a plan. And God plan along with work, sister and brother. Amen. Bible tell us by we accepting him now, he said, for we are his workmanship, created into Christ Jesus in the good works. Amen. Which God have before ordained that we should walk in them. Amen, sister and brother. Everything that need to be done, he did it, amen, in order that we might walk in the newness of this life. Amen. Without accepting him, you will never walk in the newness of life. But you can if you accept him. How do you accept him? By confessing with the mouth, believing in the heart that it was God raised Jesus from the dead, the same shall be saved. And he said, I give you eternal life. And he said, when I give it to you, you will never perish. Amen. Let's go on down now to this 11th verse. Amen. Wherefore, remember that ye being in time past Gentiles in the flesh. Amen. Talking about before we were that, before he had accepted us, sister and brother, before we had made Jesus our choice, who are called uncircumcision, amen, by that which is called the circumcision in the flesh, made by hand. You make something by hand, amen, sister and brother, is there any hope in it? No. Amen. The Bible tell us, as we move on down to this script verse, that at that time, amen, sister and brothers, at that time, ye were without Christ. Amen. Until we accept him, we was without him, sister and brothers. Amen. Being alienated, amen, from the commonwealth of Israel, and strangers from the covenant, the promise, the covenant that God had promised us, sister and brother, we wouldn't have a hope. Amen. The promise of promise, amen, having no hope. Amen. Without God in this world. Amen. Sister and brother, without accepting him, what kind of hope do we have?
None.
We don't have that bit of hope.
Amen.
Amen, sister and brother, until we accept him for our personal Savior. The Bible tells us, and we move on down to the 13th verse here, but now. Mm-hmm. Amen, but now, sister and brother, this is talking about a change. Amen. But now, in Christ Jesus, ye, who sometime were far off, amen, are made nigh, how? By the blood of Christ. Amen, sister and brother. We don't have no hope without the blood of Christ. Amen. And he shed his blood. Amen. In order for us to make this journey, he died for the sin of the whole entire world. Amen. He loved us when we wasn't lovable.
Amen.
The Bible tells us, as we move on down to this 14th verse here, amen, for he is our peace. Maybe I need to pause here. Who is our peace? Mm-hmm. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen, sister and brother. He has given us peace when we accept him for our personal Savior. Amen. Who have made both one. Made both one. Who are the both, sister and brother? He talking about the Jews and Gentiles. He brought us as one, sister and brother. Amen. And have broke down the middle wall of partition. Amen. Between us. We, amen, is a new creation. And we serve now, amen, the same God. We serve him because what he has done for us, amen, by shedding his blood and the Holy Spirit taking his abode in us to live in us. Now, sisters and brothers, we can, amen, be what he wants us to be. What have he done for us? Let's look at this 15th verse here. Having abolished in his flesh, Jesus did this. Amen. The enmity, even the law of commandment containing into order, for to make in himself, talking about Jesus now, of twain one new man, so making peace. Amen. We can do it, sister and brother, because the work that have been wrought by who? By our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. He have did it right by himself. And by him doing this, sisters and brothers, we are on our way somewhere. We are on our way to glory if you know who Jesus is. Amen. But you have to, amen, accept him, because if we don't, there are no hope. But if you know him, then, sister and brother, there are hope in the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. And now, what have he done for us? Because the one time, sister and brother, Jews and Gentiles didn't get along. Amen. They will go miles and miles around to keep from just seeing a Gentile. But now, sister and brother, what have he done for you? What he have done for the Gentiles and Jews? He have brought us as one, according to the scriptures. The Bible tells us, as we look at this 16th verse here, amen, he let us to know, and that he might reconcile both now into God in one body. Amen. By the cross, having slain the enmity, amen, thereby the hate that was between the Jews and the Gentiles. Now he has brought us together as one when we accept him for our personal Savior. Let's go on down now to this 17th verse here. Amen. And came, amen, and preached peace into you which were afar off. Maybe I need to pause here. Who were the one who were far off? Amen. We Gentiles. The Jews always, he dealt with them, amen, years ago. But we were far off, amen, to them that was nigh. Who is them that were nigh? One group nigh and the other far off. The nigh was Jews. Amen, sister and brother. The Bible tells us, as we move on down to this 18th verse, for through him, amen, talking about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we both, Jews and Gentiles now, have access, amen, by one Spirit into the Father. By the one Spirit, amen, the one Spirit is the Holy Ghost that dwell within every believer, everyone who have made Jesus their choice. Amen, sister and brother. The Bible tell us, as we move on down now to this 19th verse, now therefore, amen, ye are no more strangers. We were strangers before we accept him, Jews and Gentiles, because they didn't have nothing to do with one another. Amen, and firmly, amen, but fellow citizen with the saints now, amen, and of the household of God. And let us to know God have quickened us and have made us alive that we may have this love in our heart towards one another. Amen. We as believers, we shouldn't despise nobody. We ought to love what caused us to love, because God has shed that love abroad in our heart, and it called us to love those that is unlovable, those that will not, amen, accept you. Amen. But you have to love whom God love. Amen. Who do God love? God love everybody. Amen. Now he have quickened us and made us alive. What this calls us to do? Calls us to love everybody. I didn't say loving ways. Amen. I said loving one another. God have ordained that. Amen. And a build upon the foundation. This is the 20th verse. Amen. Of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Amen. Amen. He is head of all of this, sister and brother. He is the one who has seen fit, amen, that we may live throughout eternity. He did it all right by himself. Amen. In whom all the building fit framed together growed into a holy temple in the Lord. Amen. The Bible tell us, as we move on down to this 22nd verse here, and in whom ye also are built together for a habitation of God through the Spirit. By the Holy Spirit, sister and brother, we all become one. Amen. We owe him nothing but a praise. Amen. It's not because the work of righteousness that we have done, but it's what Jesus has done. Amen. What caused him to do it? Amen. Love. The Bible tells us God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. We have this everlasting life because of love. Love, amen. And now that love is shedded abroad in our heart. What do it call us to do now? It calls us now to love one another. Amen. And we have that, whereabout? In earthly vessels. Amen. You can't see it, but know you is the change because, amen, your love life change. Amen. You love that what wasn't lovable. Amen. Mankind what isn't lovable. You can love him. I didn't say love his ways, but amen. Jesus loved us when we were yet sinners. Amen. We didn't have nothing for him to do, but he did it all right by himself. Now, sister and brother, we have him now. We are to be like him, loving those that spitefully misuse us. Amen. Those who haven't made Jesus their choice yet. Amen. What is our job? Amen. For them to pray for them. Amen. If you hate them, you gonna pray for somebody you hate? No. Amen. When you love somebody, you can pray for them. Amen. Jesus loved us, and that's why he was able to love us when we were yet sinners. Now he prayed for us while we were sinners. Amen, sister and brother. Now we have that on the inside of us, and we shouldn't have that hate. We just have that envy. Amen. We have to have that the love of God in our heart. God bless you. God bless you. Don't clock on the wall. Don't clock on the wall. And then that can know time for me to get out of here. But if you're enjoying this radio program, will you write me a letter sometime? Walter Atkins Jr., Post Office Box 1142, Tarver, North Carolina. This is Walter Atkins Jr. saying,